Hello everyone, my name is EquilibriumEST and this is my Elder Scrolls Online gameplay series, episode number 8. That's nice when a group ends up in a place with me.
I suspect that Vardan died when the portal closed. The body cannot survive without the soul. The Bloodthorns created a portal to the spirit realm with this Welkin stone. Vardan is on the other side, commanding the spirits, slaying the orcs. He's trapped over there since we closed the portal. Without the Breton ritual Vardan used, only one without a soul can cross the portal. That means you. You
oh,
must
nice.
Activate the Welkin stone.
You're too late. My army feeds.
Strange that such a small thing can cause such terror. It must be destroyed.
Hold on, let's think about this.
What's to think about? It killed hundreds of orcs.
The cultist did that. In the right hands, this could defend the Covenant against invaders.
I'm not giving that thing to the people who leveled
Orsinium. Hey, that's the vision I saw.
Destroy the relic now! Didn't you hear the screams as those things consumed the souls of my people? It should be an easy one. You must destroy it. Do not hand it to the ones who leveled Orsinium and try to exterminate all my kind.
Orsinium used to be the Orc homeland. Breton and Redguard kings have a nasty habit of burning it to the ground. Now the Covenant will solve all our problems. You give them the relic, they'll use it to keep orcs in line. If not,
this object is a curse, a danger to all. It can be turned against anyone as easily as Vardan turned it against the orcs. Unless you want me as an enemy, destroy that thing.
The relic, ours at last, for the Covenant. Yes, keep it and use it. A discovery like this could tip the war in our favor. Think of all the lives we could save.
While using others.
With this relic, our enemies would not dare invade the Covenant. No more Pact raids out of Skyrim. No Dominion fleets in our waters. Think of a whole ocean here, not just the waves. It's what we must do to protect our people.
I will fuck this shit up. Screw this.
You're too late. My army feeds.
Where is this guy now? Hello. Hello. You are an orc. Chest. Shut die. Jesus Christ. I'm not really good with locks, I have to say, unfortunately.
So, you decided the fate of the relic. What did you decide to do with the relic? The only correct choice. War should be honorable. There is no honor in the use of such a device. You have saved my tribe and my island. For this, I owe you a great debt. One less alien relic to plague our world. Good. Your actions have revealed a vulnerability. I thought my tribe safe on our island. This Bloodthorn attack proved me wrong. Only you and your friends on the Spearhead united were able to save this island. Months ago, Sir Lannis offered membership in the Daggerfall Covenant. I refused. You showed me I was wrong. We need allies. I would ask you to travel to Glenumbra and give Sir Lannis my protection.
I will work some stuff and sell some stuff and then we will head to Captain. Is this the right side?
Victory!
Have pity.
Yeah, that's the correct one. Ooh, no, I haven't. I haven't researched traits yet. Right, not sure if I want to break it though. Ah, screw it. Alright. Precise and sharpened. Ah, fine, I will give it. Which stuff would I like? Ice stuff was pretty nice. Although lightning was good as well. Let's take electric stuff. Well, no, let's take ice stuff, because with ice stuff I can stop the enemies. That's cool. So I'm missing the Breton.
Hail, O Wayfarer. I'm certainly... Well...
Molybdenum it's the one that I need. God damn it.
Hail, O.
Oh yeah, so this way I can upgrade the level as well. Cool. Yeah, fine. May not have been the best idea. Cool. Fine. Let's check the bank to see if I have the enchantment stuff to upgrade my stuff.
Hey, feeling generous?
We built this bank to last.
And I could put this one there. Alright, let's leave this place then. Oi. Oh yeah, minimum level 10, so cannot do that.
I swore never to sail with you again, but Chief Tazgul has asked me to sail you to Glenumbra, which I will do. Only out of respect for the Chief and for the good of the Alliance, not for you. Are you ready to go?
Why so angry? Why so mad? I only broke a relic which would have changed the outcome of the whole world, but what? It's just me. I didn't like it.
We've arrived. Welcome to Daggerfall.
Right, so this is Daggerfall, eh?
There you are. Do not panic. Only you can see me. Come, we have to talk.
Oh my god, I'm hearing voices.
The proud city of Daggerfall greets you. Can I help you with something? The Seamount Warchief? Impressive. I don't know what you did to convince him, friend. but you have my gratitude. Well done. I will take this petition to High King Emmerich immediately. Enjoy your stay.
There you are, Vestige. We must speak at once. Listen well. I have located a safe harbor from which we might plan our course of action. You must meet me there. I awoke in a city of Bretons, its air heavy with the smells of baked bread, horses, and intrigue. Daggerfall, the harborage is in an abandoned cave outside the city.
Find harborage. Okay, fine. Charge! The fuck is this? Is this the Storm Astronaut thingy? Maybe.
Welcome to the harborage, Vestige. This is as comfortable a home as an old dried-up husk like myself could hope for. Despite my blindness, nay, because of it, my other senses seem to have heightened. This place had the right smell about it. Indeed, but let us not get ahead of ourselves. Without an understanding of where we are bound, every road will get us nowhere. Before we truly understand our destination, we must speak of the past. Of a sort. I invite you to enter my mind and walk with me through visions of the past, that you might understand the events that brought us to this time, this moment. Enter my mind, Vestige, and walk with me through the shadows of past events.
Uh-oh. Shiitake!
Follow me, Vestige, and learn of the events that precipitated our current crisis.
Slowest blind guy ever.
My began when I awoke on the steps of the Abbey of the Moth Priests.
Slowest guy ever. Blindness is not the excuse.
Moth Priests took pity upon me and brought me into their fold. I was weak and near death. It was there I first set eyes upon the Elder Scrolls and devoted my life to their study. The scrolls allowed me to glimpse the very fabric of reality, but each profound insight dimmed my vision and eventually left me permanently blinded to the light of the world. The prophecies of the Elder Scrolls are a fluid living thing. They are not fixed. I only know that you are important, Vestige. The scrolls reveal to me that your destiny is intertwined with that of the Five Companions. The Five Companions were a band of adventurers who sought out an ancient artifact called the Amulet of Kings. They hoped to use this artifact to persuade Akatosh, the Dragon God, to accept their leader as one of the Dragonborn. The Dragonborn are mortals destined for greatness. With the blood of the dragons in their veins. It is said there only a true dragon
ignite
the eternal dragon fires in the Imperial City. Baron Aquilarius, the son of Calobian Duke, who led a rebellion against the Emperor Leovic and took the crown himself. Alas, Baron was not truly a dragonborn, as those who sit upon the Ruby Throne must be, in accordance with tradition. You have already heard enough babbling from this old blind fool. It is time you met the five companions yourself and witnessed their fate. The first companion, Lyris Titanborn, daughter of giants, was the mightiest warrior in the service of the Emperor. Next, Abner Farn, a powerful sorcerer and Grand Chancellor to the Imperial Elder Council. The Red Guard Swordmaster, Sai Sahan, leader of the Imperial Dragon Guard. The Imperial Emperor, Varen Aquilarius, who attempted to light the dragonfires and failed. And finally, Manamarco, the traitor, the King of Worms, a powerful necromancer, and your executioner.
You bastard.
These were the five companions who set out from the Imperial City on an epic quest to recover the lost amulet of kings. Manimarco convinced Varen that the amulet could be used to perform a ritual that would rekindle the dragonfires. He claimed this would please Akatosh and entice him to adopt Varen as one of the Dragonborn. By tradition, only the Dragonborn can lay claim to the Ruby Throne and rule as the one true emperor by divine right. Varen conquered Cyrodiil and took the throne, but unless he became Dragonborn, he feared he'd always be thought of as a pretender. Each of the five companions were chosen for their skill and courage, and each was given a special role to perform in the party. Who would you like to know more about? These were the five. Many marker. By tradition, only the dragon. Each of the five. You've already met Lyris. She's a Nord warrior from the frozen lands of Skyrim to the north. And it is said that her family lineage contains the blood of giants. Varen chosen. Sai Sahan came from a long line of Red Guard Swordmaster nobles. He was the leader of the Dragon Guard, the security detail of Varen and the Elder Council. While Lyris was Varen's bodyguard, Sai was charged with protecting the entire group. The Therns are one of the most influential families in Cyrodiil. Abner, their patriarch, is the leader of the Elder Council, a powerful battle mage and a shrewd politician. With his council, Varen was able to seize the Imperial Throne years before. Manimarco the traitor, the great enemy, the most powerful necromancer this world has ever known. His worm cult infiltrates and corrupts every corner of Tamriel.
Oh, I want to be just like him.
Perform the ritual you are about to witness. Disaster, war, and pestilence. A world brought to its knees. Now watch and see how one man's arrogance brought about the greatest threat our world has ever known.
There it is. The dragon fire brazier. Manimarco. You certain this will work?
It will work, my liege. The Amulet of Kings will rekindle the dragon fires and ensure your rightful place as Emperor. You have my word.
It better work, Manimarco, or you'll find your neck at the business end of my axe.
My lord, I wonder if you'd muzzle your half-giant pet. She really is annoying.
Enough, both of you. We are here to ensure my lord's rightful claim to the Ruby Throne.
Abner.
Ah, that's why Lyris was so tall.
By the lighting of the dragon fires, I claim my rightful lineage. By the fires of creation, let me be reborn. By the will of Akatosh, I proclaim myself Dragonborn.
Ah! Ah!
Messiah. You will pay for your sacrilege. The veil between Tamriel and Oblivion tears and splits asunder.
What's happening? The sky is opening up. This is bad. This is very bad. Ah!
This isn't supposed to happen. What's the meaning of this? Manimarco, what have you done?
Gullible fools! The veil between Oblivion and this world has been torn. My master, Molag Bal, is free to claim Tamriel for his own.
Akatosh, forgive me! Have mercy on our souls!
Okay.
The ritual tore the veil between Nern and Oblivion, allowing Manimarco to begin stealing the souls his master needed to power the dark anchors and initiate the plane melt. Akatosh gave Alessia the Amulet of Kings as a symbol of his covenant with Nern. So long as the amulet remained in the care of Alessia's heirs and the dragon fires remained lit, Tamriel would be protected from the Daedra. Manimarco tricked Varin into breaking the covenant, and the veil between Oblivion and Nern was torn. The Elder Scrolls named this event the Soul Burst. It gave Molag Bal the opportunity to disconnect the souls of Nern from their hosts. Varin was lost. In the chaos of the moment, Sai Sahan took the Amulet of Kings and fled. Leris was captured by Manimarco and delivered to Cold Harbor, the realm of Molag Bal. Tharn remains Chancellor of the Elder Council, and his daughter Clibio rules as Empress Regent, but the true power remains in the hands of Manimarco and his worm cult. When I discovered the truth about the five companions, I made subtle inquiries, but apparently not subtle enough. Manimarco got word of my interest and abducted me. He took me to Cold Harbor, where I remained a prisoner until you freed me. The truth is always a threat to evil men. Manimarco feared I would reveal his treachery, and if knowledge of Nan's vulnerability were to become known, it could threaten his master's schemes. Molag Bal does not favor loose ends. Walk with me.
Why'd you walk so slow? Ugh.
Long ago it was written, so long as the Amulet of Kings was born by Alessia's heirs, Tamriel would be protected from the forces of Oblivion. But the Soul Burst tore the veil between worlds and gave Molag Bal the opportunity he desired. Molag Bal's dark anchors pierce the torn veil and seek to draw Nern into the depths of Cold Harbor. These terrible engines of destruction have been appearing all throughout Tamriel.
That's nasty.
Survive the ordeal, and those that do will be enslaved for all eternity. And so it falls to us, Vistage, as you say.
Okay, and right here, right now, it's time to end episode number 8 of my Elder Scrolls Online gameplay series. So, thank you for watching me, subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next game episode. Bye-bye!